Yeah, last year was, you know, we just played, went into the postseason. That's all our whole team played. So it was kind of different this year. We played with all our team. But, you know, the same thing, the similar thing is we're coming together at the end. We're playing hard. We're playing the right way. We're executing the game plan perfectly. So that's the same thing and differently, a little bit different team. We're kind of smaller this year, but we got to change up some stuff and come out after it.
And you did last year?
Yeah, the CSA's packed this year. You know, it always is, but we don't approach it any different. Last year we were looked at as underdogs because we didn't have any of our pieces, and we just came out and played our game and played the style we know how to play and executed the game plan. We got it done in the postseason, and that's what we're looking for this year. Yeah, it was a Thursday, and I called Coach Kennedy, and I let him know that I was going to come to Texas A&M. And, you know, I've been knowing for a while after I came off my visit, and it's just a great place academically and athletically for me. I love the coaching staff, the facilities, the people down there, my teammates. I just love everything about it.
I think it's different for probably everybody that goes through that. Did you enjoy it, not like it, or was it just something you had to do as far as the whole process?
Oh, I loved it. You know, yeah. going to different schools, meeting different coaches, seeing them on TV, and meeting all these players, some of them in the NBA now, and talking to all these different coaches. I love the recruiting experience.
What was the best, you know, experience you had out there doing that?
Oh, probably the Texas A&M visit. You know, that blew my mind. And to interact with the coaches like that and see that much love from them and them show me that much. And it was probably the best experience, and that's one of the reasons I'm going there.
Well, we knew even in eighth grade, I saw him shoot the ball. I said, he's going to be a heck of a player. And one thing he was able to do, too, is pass the ball. He sees he's a step ahead of most, and he sees things materialize before they do, and that's what makes a good basketball player, too. But last year, again, we did, like I said before, we didn't really see him as a junior. Because he got his true junior year. He really, that summer was the end of, you know, part of his junior year anyway, when he got stronger in the summer. But his strength from last year to this year is unreal. Just the way he's jumping, he gets the ball and two or three guys hanging on him, he's able to go through them. That's the biggest difference I see. Well, I think they're gonna use him any way they can. I mean, definitely gonna be, he's gonna have to move without the ball. I mean, he's going to come off screens, and he's going to have to catch and shoot. He's going to put it on the floor. They might even use him to bring the ball up, too. So I know in other colleges we're talking about using him as a 1-2 and a 3. And Texas A&M, I know he's got a chance to play there soon. And I think when he gets there, he's going to put on – they're going to really get him, and he's going to get a ton of shots more in. And they're going to get him in the weight room, and he's going to be able to play all over, I think.
we have a about 7-foot rim downstairs, okay. And we have about 9-10-foot ceilings, so you can't block jump shots, but we got a little painted area you can block. So it's challenging there. It makes you use your body, and the tall guys usually lose because they can't get an arch on their shot, but it's fun down there.
What do your teammates and friends can play with you?
Oh yeah. It's a big thing. You know, we got teammates from the past, my old friends, and everybody wants to come down there and play, and we always get going down there. It's a lot of fun. They call me Mr. D1, Mr. Aggie, Clutch Allen, because I hit the Lincoln buzzer beater, stuff like that, yeah. A lot of basketball terms.
Any of them you prefer better?
Not really, just no. Peyton. One time I came out for the game, we were about ready to run on the court, and I saw I had my shorts on backwards, so I had to go back in the locker room. I think I just did it right there, and I switched them around real quick, but you know, it was pretty embarrassing. About to run out on the court, freshman year too, so I had to get them right back on, and that was probably the most embarrassing
thing. That's a freshman
mistake. Exactly, yeah.